Why do plants need water? The same reasons for which humans need water. Water constitutes a major part of the plant body. This water helps plants to transport the nutrients in their body and is quite important for the growth of the plant. How do plants get their water? The roots help the plant absorb the water from the soil. It indicates that moist soil would mean a continuous supply of water to plants. Do you know that the plants need water right from their germination? Have you heard people say that the seeds will wither away if there is no water? After sowing, seeds need water to germinate, and that's precisely why farmers sow seeds before the rains. But what if there are no rains? How do plants then get water? Irrigation is the solution to this problem. The supply of water to crops at specific intervals is known as irrigation. We need to understand that plants need water more than anything else. Water acts as a shield against the extremities of nature like frost or hot currents. No doubt, water is of foremost importance to the crop. That is why we will study irrigation as a process of production. Do you know what irrigation depends on? Can you guess? Yes, it depends on the soil type. And what, according to you, will the frequency of irrigation depend on? Can you guess? Yes, it does depend on the season. During summer, soil is devoid of moisture. This is because the heat leads to a higher rate of evaporation. That is why we need to irrigate the fields frequently during the summer months. During the monsoons, there is a little need for irrigation. Now let us look at the sources of irrigation. What are the sources of irrigation? Ponds, wells, lakes, dams, rivers are various water bodies that help supply water for irrigation. However, the methods of irrigation have changed over the years. In irrigation, water is lifted from water bodies and then carried to the fields. In the traditional method, who do you think does the work of lifting the water? It's the cattle or humans who lift water from these sources. These methods were inexpensive for the farmers, but were not quite efficient. Let us take a quick look at a few traditional methods of irrigation first. We will look at the moat or pulley system, a chain pump, dhekli, and rahat, which is a lever system. The first system is where water is pulled out of water source with the help of a pulley. The pulley can be moved in several ways to then carry the bucket of water to different places in the field. But this kind of irrigation requires human labor. There is also another problem of uneven distribution of water. Thus, this type of irrigation is less efficient. What about the next type? A chain pump? This is an interesting method. A bucket is tied to a wheel and this wheel is pulled by a chain. This wheel is placed above a water body. The wheel, when it turns, lets water to be collected inside the bucket. This bucket then pours the water out when it comes onto the top. Water then flows into the field in the man-made canal-like system. Here as well, human labor may be required to pull the chain. What about the dhekli? This system of irrigation requires two people, or a load needs to be kept attached to the log. Which log? Can you see that V-shaped log is fixed to the ground in an erect manner? Now there is another log that is placed between its forked branch. This log has a bucket attached to one end. When the log is moved, it helps lower the bucket and get a bucket full of water from the well. This water is then dropped into a narrow canal-like system that waters the fields. This method leads to wastage of water. Now what about the last system? The rahat system? This is a 1,300-year-old method of irrigation which now is almost extinct. This one requires two wheels. One wheel is attached with several buckets all around its circumference and is placed halfway inside the water body. The other is placed on the ground with a rod attached to it. This rod is placed horizontally. It can be made to move in a circle. Usually, cattle are made to operate the system. Humans do it at times too. When the rod is moved in a circular manner, it rotates the two wheels in turn. The wheel which is inside the water body collects water into the buckets and deposits it onto the surface. Canal-like systems then carry the water to different parts of the field. Wasn't this wonderful to learn? But do these methods exist even today? Well, we'll find that out in our next lesson. There we will study the modern methods of irrigation.